Hello friend. And welcome to this channel. This video will give you a quick review of dermatology topic, malignant melanoma. Melanoma is a malignant tumor of epidermal melanocyte. While only 4% of skin cancers are melanomas, they account for 80% of skin cancer deaths. Risk factors for melanoma include following: incidence is high in fair-skinned people. Other risk factors include freckles, red hair, number of nevi, and short periods of intensive sunlight exposure during early age. A family history of melanoma increases the risk, but a strong family history is unusual. Rarely, due to mutations in certain genes, autosomal dominant inheritance of melanoma, with incomplete penetrance can occur. In these patients, the lifetime risk of melanoma is more than 50%.
Clinical features. Melanoma can occur at any age and site, and in either sex. Typically, affects the leg in females, and back in males. It is rare before puberty. Generally, the melanomas are irregular, dark lesions with rough surface. If lesion is smooth, well demarcated, and regular, it is unlikely to be a melanoma. But diagnosis can be tricky. Glasgow 7-point checklist and ABCDE criteria are used clinically for picking up suspicious lesions. Most, but not all melanomas have features described by these criteria. So, if in doubt, refer to experts.
ABCDE criteria include following features: asymmetry of lesion, border is irregular in melanomas, color is non-uniform, diameter greater than 7 mm, and elevation of the lesion. Early lesions may be in situ and pre-invasive, before becoming invasive melanoma with metastatic potential. Any change in nevi or development of new lesions should be assessed to exclude malignancy. Dermatoscope is an invaluable tool for this purpose. If there is any doubt, excision is advised. Types of melanomas include melanoma without metastatic potential and melanoma with metastatic potential. Melanoma without metastatic potential include melanoma in situ and lentigo maligna. Melanoma with metastatic potential include superficial spreading melanoma, nodular melanoma, acrylentigenus melanoma, lentigo maligna melanoma, and subungual melanoma. Now, brief features of these, one by one. Superficial spreading melanoma is the most common type. It has radial growth. That is, it tends to grow horizontally across epidermal and superficial epidermal planes. Since it does not reach lymphatics and blood vessels, so the prognosis tends to be good. Nodular melanoma. This is most common in the 5th and 6th decades, particularly in men. It is found on the trunk. It has greater metastatic potential and have poor prognosis among all types of melanoma. Lesions may develop de novo or from a pre-existing nevus or superficial spreading melanoma. Its growth is in the vertical plane and tends to be dome-shaped. They may present as a rapidly growing nodule that may bleed and ulcerate. Nodular melanomas are heavily pigmented, but are amelanotic in 5% cases. Acrylentigenus. This type is more common in dark-skinned people and are confined to palms, soles, and nails. Next is lentigo maligna and lentigo maligna melanoma. Lentigo maligna is pre-invasive stage which may last for years and has risk of malignant transformation. It occurs as a very slowly expanding, pigmented, macular lesion, usually on photo-exposed head and neck sites of elderly patients. Histology, it shows in situ changes only. This phase may last for several years before a nodule of invasive melanoma develops in a proportion of cases. It is then termed as lentigo maligna melanoma. Subungual melanoma. This form of melanoma is rare. It may present as a painless, proximally expanding streak of pigmentation arising from the nail matrix and progresses to nail dystrophy and involvement of the adjacent nail fold. Determinants of prognosis. There are several determinants, which if present, show poor prognosis. Depth of invasion is the most important factor. Breslow's thickness is the thickness of the tumor beneath the epidermis, and correlates inversely with prognosis. Other determinants of poor prognosis include spread to regional lymph nodes, presence of metastases, and ulceration. Coming on to the treatment. Excision of the lesion, with 2 mm healthy skin margin is done. After histology, wider excision is carried out. Sentinel node biopsy is sometimes undertaken, to determine local spread, which helps determine treatment and prognosis. All patients should be advised regarding ongoing photoprotection. It is also prudent to optimize oral vitamin D, through diet and supplements. Treatment options in metastatic disease are mostly palliative. Chemotherapy gives a response in 10-30% with metastatic disease. Ipilimumab, which is a human monoclonal antibody, has been shown to improve survival in patients with metastatic melanoma. Prognosis. Patients with a primary tumor of less than 1 mm Breslow thickness have more than a 95% chance of disease-free survival at 10 years. But this figure drops to approximately 50% for a tumor of greater than 3.5 mm thickness. Survival rates fall further, to less than 10% for those with advanced nodal or metastatic disease. Prevention. As therapy for advanced and metastatic disease remains unsatisfactory, primary prevention and early detection are essential. The disease can be prevented by reducing exposure to the sun, using high-factor sunscreen, and wearing protective clothing. And this is it for this video. We hope you've learned some useful information from this video. If so, please like our video and share with your colleagues. Consider subscribing to this channel to get notifications about latest videos.